Part of our family business strategy is to ensure that we have a sustainable farming operation, and that means that we have to look after our environment, our cattle and our people. Melinee Leather, Barfield Station. We've got a finishing operation here at Barfield. We have three properties spread over 17,500 hectares, running about 4,500 head of cattle at the moment. When we think of looking after our cattle, the important thing is, you know, making sure that we've got sufficient supply of good quality feed, adequate supplies of good quality clean water as well. So that's really about matching your stocking rate with your carrying capacity. And so we do things like grass budgeting, so we're constantly measuring our grasses, SIBO mapping to look at our biodiversity and land cover. Another thing is, of course, the introduction of leucaenas and other legumes to ensure that, you know, cattle have a good supply of highly nutritious feed at all times. Animal welfare is really important to us, and it's not just about, you know, that fact that we really care for our animals and we want to ensure that they have the best life possible, but good animal welfare will also equate to better productivity and profitability for us as a business as well. Making sure that they've got adequate supply of feed and water, low stress stock handling, the use of pain relief when we're doing aversive practices, making sure that everyone's trained and competent in animal husbandry and handling of cattle. With changing technology and new innovations, I think we have to be able to step up and utilise those as they become available to us. And I suppose a good example of that is the use of pain relief. For many years, there wasn't a product available to us, whereas now we have products that are readily available. I think when things like that come on the market, it's important that we uptake that. A really important part of your herd management is the genetics of that. Certainly when we're purchasing bulls, all of our bulls must have EBVs, so estimated breeding values. We have certain traits that we're looking for, things like the poll gene, the 200, 400, 600 day growth rates are important to us, days to calving. We have to be very mindful of which market the cattle are going into. So for instance, the EU grasslands cattle have to be very careful that, you know, there's no use of hormones. They're a natural grass-fed animals. Never in their lifetime have they been fed grain products or antibiotics. The markets will overlap a little bit, so it was a very easy progression for us to go into organic or the global animal partnership. Because of the way that we operate, we have to think of things according to the market, the age at branding, the age at weaning, all of those types of things. Being part of these markets, we have annual audits, particularly with Organic Global Animal Partnership and Australian Certified Humane is a third party independent annual audit. So we have to ensure that we've got the records to back up the claims that we're making. We have to be able to show the records of what we've done with husbandry procedures, and basically the claims that we make to how that they're raised. The other great thing that we've found since we've moved into these markets is our cost of production has dropped, so we have very little input, which means that's more dollars in our pocket. But when we start to see environmental benefits, we know that we're getting productivity gains and making more money at the end of the day. But we're also improving our environmental footprint, so we know that our ground cover's improved, or the biodiversity of species is improving. And I mean, they're things that we don't just say are happening, we do measure them. We have assessments on the ground and we keep a record of changes as we go along. Our business has decided to be in line with the red meat carbon neutral by 2030. That's the journey we're on at the moment, is how are we going to place our business to get to that point. So we've started a few things. We've got involved with a project called Method to Market, where we're doing some on-farm benchmarking. So we've done soil sampling, we've looked at cattle numbers, we've looked at our inputs such as diesel fuel, fertilisers, which we don't use. We've got a number of properties that we're running quite a lot of solar. One of our properties is entirely 100% solar run. We've got about 29 solar water pumps across our three properties. Part of our business strategy is to have 10,000 acres under leucaena. The woody growth of the leucaena sequesters carbon. We've certainly noticed that it is definitely getting hotter and drier, and we're getting more of those extreme weather events. So how are we going to manage for that? Leucaena has definitely been something that's helped us with that, because it is fairly drought tolerant. And we know that we're going to have a reasonably high protein feed source even when it's quite dry. Water's another really big important thing, and it's really about supply. And I think we're not getting the same runoff water into our dams, so groundwater's fairly critical. You know, another really important aspect of becoming carbon neutral is looking at our herd structures, the size and shape of the animals, the big framed heavy bullocks that you kept for, you know, 4 and 6 year old are sort of gone. We're looking for something that's smaller, it's going to get the fat on quicker, better yielding animal. Really important when we're looking at our EBVs to pick out those traits in the EBV that are going to give us that result. Part of our family's business strategy is continuous education, and it's a really important aspect of how we take our business forward. So we look to a lot of different people to collaborate with when we're doing our training. We find that MLA is really important to us as a service provider, and certainly the research and development that happens there and the tools and technology that they can give us to help improve our business is invaluable to us. We like to collaborate with our local DAF, so Department of Agriculture, Fisheries and Forestry, and also our local catchment groups, which here is the Fitzroy Basin Association, and our other two properties, it's the Burnett Mary Regional Group. So we find that working with these teams of people really assists us to try and do the best job we can, but they're also giving us that, you know, new technology and information as it comes out.